What If I'm Not Real? An electronic installation where masked figures, each on a raft at sea, emerge across a circular triptych of three video projections. The events on the three screens are synchronized, allowing the actions by one character to have an immediate effect on another character on a different screen. Here, the stabbing of the pen on the paper happens exactly simultaneously with the injury to the character on the right-hand screen. The child on the left screen simultaneously hears something painful. Below the net is an old TV monitor stranded on some rocks.
Was it also
The screens are roughly made using a projection gauze stretched between coarse bamboo. From behind any one screen, the other screens can still be visible. What If I'm Not Real uses the net to represent a global ensnaring structure around which a minimalist yet epic drama unfolds. The net plays an active role in that the viewer can choose to stay outside, but only by crawling underneath can the poetry underpinning the narrative on the small TV be engaged with properly. This is the lone, little heard, and intimate voice of the displacement inherent in such migration.
On the piece of blank paper, I love it.
Watching the screens from below the net, in fact through the net, creates a different relationship with the narrative. Each screen not only has a particular character projected onto it, but is also associated with a particular sound, whether musical or otherwise, by means of a system of speakers each located near each screen. The resulting soundscape creates an incredibly vibrant atmosphere in the space. What If I'm Not Real uses the Chinese notion of opposites throughout. For example, the water allows tranquility and safety from the conflicts of land, yet remains uncomfortable and disturbing since prolonged residence here is not possible. The blood represents both life and death, played out to dramatic effect by the adult's decision to synthesize it into a dangerous fuel. The visual narrative across the three screens is here shown as a horizontal flattened presentation. Three people appear on separate screens, each on a raft, an official in the center, an adult on the right, and a child on the left. The official carefully lets out lengths of string with sharp spiked barbs into the water. The adult is searching for something in the water. A child plays, hopping about with odd pieces of wood. The official is now floating army tanks into the water and sending them off. The adult then finds a string and pulls it in, gets hurt by the barbs, but finds the end has been cut. It leads nowhere. The child finds and starts to pull in a piece of barbed string too. The adult finds another piece of string with barbs, this time with a broken fragment of a photograph on the end. She sadly holds it to her heart with a sense of loss. The official has now found some money floating in the water, which he adds to other money along with his military supplies. The child finds the end of her string cut and leading nowhere. The official shines a searchlight to survey his immediate area, dazzling and hurting the child and adult on their respective screens. The official then removes his gloves before making a personal phone call. The child begins to examine the many broken fragments of photographs scattered on her raft, trying to find two pieces that fit together. The adult is now occupied trying to sew two pieces of cloth together. The thread she has is too short to be of any use. The official, having finished his call, sees himself in the mirror but can't look at himself. As the adult spreads the cloth on her lap, we see them as having borders and lines marking out connecting routes as if they are landmaps, the borders of which she can never mend. Then the official prepares to sign a document, yet looks around for a suitable subject. The adult nervously paces left and right. As the official stabs his pen, the adult is simultaneously shot in the tummy, and the child covers her ears as if having heard a scream. The adult receives another shot from the official's stabbing pen. Red blood appears where the adult is shot and also comes out from the official's pen onto his paper as he writes. Finds another barbed string, this time with a broken photograph and also a piece of paper attached to the cut end. The adult squeezes blood from her clothes into a glass and puts it into a bottle. She then finds more blood from the sea. And also pours this into the bottle. The adult then pushes some cotton cloth into the top of the bottle, lights it, and prepares to throw it towards the official. The child looks on anxiously, while the official drops his papers in frozen disbelief.